Santa Margarita and Eagle basketball program has lost a friend. Sadly, Mr. Bob Nicoletti was killed in an auto accident just before Christmas. Bob kept our scorebook for the better part of the last 7 years. And he did an incredible job of keeping the book as a challenge that brings pressure with it, especially during Trinity League games and playoffs.
We do not trust in ourselves or believe in our own strength. We rely solely on the power of God. We compete for the pleasure of our Heavenly Father, the honor of Christ, and the reputation of the Holy Spirit. Our attitude on and off the field is above reproach, our conduct beyond criticism. We submit to God's authority and those he has put over us. We respect our coaches, officials, teammates, and competitors out of respect for the Lord. Our bodies are temples of Jesus Christ. We protect from within and without. Our sweat is an offering to our Master. Our soreness a sacrifice to our Savior. We give it our all the time. We do not give up. We do not give in. We do not give out. We are the Lord's warrior, a competitor by conviction, and disciples of determination. We are confident beyond reason because our confidence lies in Christ. The results of our efforts must result in his glory. Let the competition begin. Let the glory be God's. St. Margaret Mary, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Tori. Thank you very much. Okay, yes, God and country. And now the country part. The national anthem to be sung by Katrina Pizak. Okay, Katrina Pizak, really nice, beautiful. Okay, and now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to introduce the teams. So please get ready. All right.
Good evening. Survive
Friars, first, ladies and gentlemen, from Survive.
Take on the Survive Friars in this Trinity League matchup. I'm Jack Frankenfield alongside my color guy, Aiden Verde. And tonight we have a pretty good matchup in store as we see the starting lineups announced right now. So Aiden, what are your thoughts going into the game?
You know, anything could happen. Just like the last game, Santa Margarita has an obvious size advantage. They might use that to their advantage. And they might use Rockwell Reynolds. Could have a big night.
So we were talking about that earlier, right? The tallest player on Servite, 6'6". We obviously have Rockwell Reynolds down low, who's been a beast all year. So that could be very important. And there's your starting lineup for the Eagles. Sticking with the same starting five they have been for the last few games. So, Aiden, going back to what we were talking about, the key really being Rockwell Reynolds down low because of the size advantage, and obviously Rockwell Reynolds having an amazing year.
Right.
He's been going absolutely off so far, so I think that could be – it's really going to come up to if Servite can contain him, I would say. And, I mean, you can see the lineup they have out there right now, a lot of shorter guys out there. So.
Well – I think what would happen is if Rockwell Reynolds were to be double teamed in the paint, then he'd be able to kick it out to one of the shooters, like Toby Averill or.
So we saw that in their last matchup, and if you didn't tune into that one, in the Eagles' last game, they played the JCR Lions on Friday the 6th. They won 56-42. But the thing is, in that game, it was very close until the end, and they were able to contain Rockwell Reynolds to 15 points, which is about the lowest we've seen from him all year. There's the tip, and Servite's going to start with the ball. Alrighty. Servite with the opening possession here. Dribbling the ball up top. Try to slow it down, see if they can get something going here. Little isolation up top on the point guard, Moxie. See the screen there. They're going to get the foul call. Ball's going to be going the other way for the Eagles.
Yeah, that was good defense by the Eagles, really applying pressure.
Yeah, absolutely. So, yeah, Rockwell Reynolds, number 13. He's going to be the one to watch here. If Servite can keep him in check, I think they have a pretty good shot in this one. As there's McNamee. And then it's going to kick it to Moxie, to Kaiman. Kaiman, the freshman, brother of SM alumni Jake Kaiman, class of 2019. All right, there he is, Rockwell Reynolds down low. But
appears he used his elbow.
Yeah, they're going to call him for the,
right.
For the offensive foul there. But as we can see there, they give it right to Rockwell, and he just hit that spin move. I think that's going to be – I'm thinking a big game from Rockwell. Alrighty, there's up top the little pull-up jumper, and he knocks it down. Number 4, Scott Scholes there, the senior. A little aggressive defense there, a little four-court press as they're going to give it to McNamee. A lot of ball movement here to start for the Eagles. There's the ball to Averill. They're going to kick it to Rockwell, but it's going to get deflected. Kaiman's going to think about it. He's going to drive. He's going to kick it to Rockwell, but it's going to go out of bounds. It's going to be Servite ball.
You know, that was a good opportunity. He saw Rockwell, but that was a pretty low pass. So Rockwell, obviously his big frame and his long wingspan couldn't get to there in time.
So I know we talked about this, Aiden. The key, what Jay Sayre really did right in the last game was they had their defensive set up. So whenever Rockwell's down low, they crashed and had a double team on him. He was kind of got trapped. So let's see if Servite can do something like that. Because that one's going to go down low, and he's going to put the layup, and no good. Rebound by McNamee.
Servite's not afraid to show their physicality down low.
No, they're not, especially with being like a small ball lineup. It's that's good to see that the very physicality. And they're going to call the
– And Eagles are getting called for a lot of offensive fouls.
Offensive fouls here. Ball's going to be going the other way. about 2 minutes into the first quarter here. Servite leads 2-0.
Both Toby and Rocco have to be careful. They both have a foul, and it's only the first quarter.
You don't want Rocco to get into foul trouble, because, again, he's really the key piece to this team. Rocco Reynolds, the senior, committed to Northern Arizona University. All right, he's going to see a little double there. Good defense from the Eagles. The shot clock starts to wind down. Shane Williams with the ball. He's going to kick it up top to number 11, Aaron Ballesteri. And that shot's going to get blocked by Moxie. Good block there. So now there's 3 seconds left in the shot clock here. Servite's going to have to put something up immediately.
Put up a quick shot.
See if they make this thing down low. The pull-up jumper's blocked by Averill. All righty. Another Eagles possession here. Moxie's going to take the ball up the court. There's the screen by Rockwell. McNamee's going to take it to the house, and it's good. Cameron McNamee gets his first points of the night. The layup to make it a 2-2 game.
A good pick and roll action. Cameron McNamee makes the screen, goes the other way, and goes for a nice little floater.
And there's number 4 up top. He's going to miss that one. All righty, we're seeing Moxie with the ball here. A lot of early ball movement, again, up top, trying to get some sort of separation here. As you see Rockwell down low in the post. He only has one guy on him. We'll see what he can do here. He's going to kick it out to Kaiman for 3.
That's the key.
Just off for Kaiman. And then Rockwell gets his own rebound. He's going to put up the little floater, and no good. And they're going to. And it looks like they're going to call the foul there. Averill's at the line here for 2. 4:39 remaining in the first quarter. As he knocks that one down to make it 3-2 for the Eagles. That's Toby Averill, the senior, or the junior, my mistake.
There's definitely going to be a lot of physicality in this game, as the refs called early fouls on the Eagles.
All right, you see a little ISO up top. Thinks about driving. Sides against it. Good perimeter defense here from the Eagles. They're not really able to get in the paint. No, there's the steal by Averill. Kaiman's going to recover it. It's going to lose the ball, but it's going to be going the Eagles' way.
That's really what Moxie's known for. You know, getting those passing lanes and get some easy steals. This Eagles team is a really defensive-minded team.
They are. Again, the perimeter defense very good. Just Servite hasn't been able to get down low at all, which is going to really be a problem for them if they can't get that going. About halfway through the first quarter here, 4 minutes to go. As Kaiman's going to drive the baseline, going to kick it out to Toby. Moxie for 3. Knocks it down. Jonathan Moxie, the point guard, gets his first points of the night.
Good ball movement. As Coach Bell would say, pass up a good shot for a better shot.
Exactly. Some wise words from Aiden Verde there.
Thank you.
All right, they're going to kick it to the corner. Nothing there. And that's going to be a 3 up top. No good. All righty, that's going to be an early 3 for McNamee. And he knocks it down. What a shot from Cameron McNamee. That's his spot there on the wing. All righty. Eagles starting to get going here. They're up 10-2. Again, look at the defense from the Eagles. They intercept that pass. It's going to be going their way.
Good defense, good ball movement. Eagles are really controlling the pace in this first quarter.
They are, and now they're starting to get the scoring going. So now, as you can see, they lead 10-2 with 3:08 left in the first quarter.
Frank, the first moments in any basketball game is important because if you get the first points, you control the tempo. That's exactly what Sam Margrave is doing.
I say it every broadcast. Trinity League basketball, high school basketball in general, it's all about momentum. You know, one play can really turn the momentum of the game because it's all about teams going on runs, you know. So right now the Eagles are on like a 8-0 run, I think, as that's going to be McNamee down low for the layup, and it's good. Eagles extend their lead to 10 points here. Largest lead of the night for the Eagles. They're on a 10-0 run.
Cameron McNamee has 7 points.
Yeah, he's off. Early. He's off to a hot start. He had a big game last night. Dropped 15 points against Jay Serra in the Eagles' previous win. Cameron McNamee, the junior. Ready, and they're going to drive to the baseline here. Euro step. Doesn't think about it. The corner three.
Good closeout.
Off the front rim there. Alrighty, Moxie's going to see if he can speed up the tempo. There's going to get it. Rockwell in the post. Rockwell's going to kick it over to McNamee for three. No good. That's a spot there on the wing. Wasn't able to knock that one down. Alrighty, they're going to kick it down low. And there's the foul call there. 2 minutes to go in this first quarter here. As Dallas Washington's going to check into the game for Toby Averill, first sub of the game for Coach Bell and his squad.
Eagles lead 12-2.
Alrighty, so we're going to have Scott Scholes, the senior for Cervite, inbounding the ball here. So they're going to give it right back to him. He's trapped down low.
Quick double team by the Eagles.
They're going to get that back out top. Going to get that ISO on Moxie, see if they can miss on. He's going to drive to the house. And there's the pull-up jumper off the front rim. Rockwell Reynolds gets the rebound.
You know, I noticed in each of the games that we commentated, the Eagles' defense rarely changes. They keep doing a high man defense.
Yeah, the perimeter defense for the Eagles is really what's good because, you know, all of their bigs are really athletic. They don't have any, like, liabilities on defense. You know, usually you might have your big man as liability. They don't have that. There's Dallas Washington down low. He's kind of trapped. Kyman for three in the corner. No good. But there's going to be a foul down low there.
Eagles have had a lot of opportunities to score from beyond the arc.
Yeah, a lot of open threes, and they've knocked a few of them down. As you can see, McNamee loves that. He loves that corner on – or not corner, the wing three. And Kyman money from that corner.
As Preston Lee subs in for Jonathan Moxie for the Eagles.
And there's a wild pass there. McNamee is able to recover it. And he's going to drive to the lane. He's going to kick it out to Kyman. Kyman with the pump fake. Kyman puts up the floater. And it's good. Braden Kyman. All right. 1:15 to go in this first quarter. The Eagles lead 14-2. Off to a good start here. As they're going to try to get down low. The double forces them to pass it out. They're going to take it to the house. And it's no good. The block by McNamee there. McNamee with 7 points on the night. It's really been,
and also
if he can get going from beyond the arc, that's really going to be a key factor for the Eagles.
He's really been a good two-way player as well.
He has, for sure. So a little contact there, the corner three, no good.
That was definitely a good play by Servite. A good play by Servite, getting a quick to number two and then going quick to number four. 50 seconds left in this first quarter.
All right, there's Preston Lee with the ball up top. They're going to kick it up to McNamee. McNamee, the deep three. That one's no good. All right, there's a little fast break here for Servite. The spin move, and it's good. Number 11, Aaron Bellastieri, gets his first points of the night. All right, we have 22 seconds left in the first quarter here. Looks like Coach Bell and his squad might be trying to hold for the final possession here.
Trying to get the final shot.
Yep. So they're going to kick it down low. Dallas Washington, he's kind of trapped down low, but he gets the layup. 10 seconds left here. Servite's going to try to get something going here. Put up a quick shot, and there's the steal by Washington. They're going to put up the three, and it's good. Right as the time expires, number 11, Aaron Bellastieri.
That'll definitely give them some light
the freshman
going second
guard.
Quarter.
Alrighty, 16-7 at the end of the first. Alrighty.
Eagles have been very disciplined.
Yeah, it's been very disciplined so far. Yeah. Very disciplined play here. Coach Bell came in here with a plan, and the perimeter defense has been great for the Eagles, as well as they've been able to knock down some shots. Alrighty. So, Aiden, at the end of this first quarter, what do you think well, you know, we've talked about what the Eagles are doing, right? What do you think Servite has to do to get back into this one? They're only down by 9, but, you know, still early. But what do you think Servite's got
to
do?
The key to what Servite has to do is they have to make their shots, because Eagles are going to play ferocious defense, and you take what you can get. you know.
Exactly. Exactly.
You have quick. You can have quick threes. Go back on defense. Get a good stop. It's each play.
As we start the second quarter here, the Eagles lead 16-7. Kick it down low to Washington. Up top, Preston Lee for three. And it's good! Preston Lee, his first points of the night.
As the defense was collapsing to the paint, it gave Preston Lee an open shot to hit, and he hit it.
Yeah, you see a lot of that, because obviously the Eagles have a lot of threats down low, so a lot of times they can kick it out for three like that. Alrighty, Servite's first possession of the quarter here. And there's Scott Schultz. He's going to kick it up top. Some ball movement, and there's a wing three. That one just off, but Schultz gets the rebound. Going to extend the possession here for the Friars. There's going to be the pull-up mid-range. It's going to get tipped, and it's going to go out of bounds and go back to Servite. All righty. About a minute into the second quarter here. Eagles lead 19-7.
Eagles really employing a seven-man roster, as the only substitutes we see are Dallas Washington and Preston Lee coming
in. We've seen that throughout the year for Coach Bell. Not many substitutions. He kind of likes to stick with his guys. That layup's no good. Rockwell Reynolds with the rebound. Alrighty, there's Preston Lee taking the ball up the court. Rockwell Reynolds getting starting a little dribble in there. Don't see that too often.
Definitely had the size matchup.
Yeah.
Quick pass for Rockwell.
A little hook shot for Rockwell, and it's good.
Again, the defense
Rockwell
collapsed
Reynolds.
On Cam, and then it gives Rockwell the open layup.
Rockwell Reynolds, his first points of the night. Obviously the star center for the Eagles. As I previously mentioned, committed to Northern Arizona University. There's the pull-up jumper. No good. Right. It's going to be a pass down low to Kyman. Kyman on the fast break and loses the ball there. It's going to be going the other way.
What Coach Bell always emphasizes with his players is to always box out. You always get into your man and to make sure they don't get any offensive rebounds. And that's what the Eagles are doing. They're not letting any chances go Servite's way.
Yeah. There's definitely a lot of going into Coach Bell's mindset as a coach. Obviously, you know, as a three-year SM basketball player yourself. Ready. 6:12 remaining here in the second quarter. As the Eagles getting off to a hot start here. Again, Servite staying on the perimeter. Great defense. It's another pull-up mid-range shot, and that one's going to fall for number 11, Aaron Bullis-Jerry. He's the freshman. Kind of interesting. They have another freshman starting for the Friars. As obviously, the Eagles have their own freshman, Braden Kyman.
Quick over the court pass.
Alrighty, there's Rockwell Reynolds down low. Bread and butter. Hook shot with two guys on him. No good.
Your favorite phrase, Frank.
Bread and butter. I mean, you know, if it's not broken, I'll fix it, you know? Rockwell Reynolds down low. It works, you know? Alrighty. Alright, there's the cross court pass. The corner three for Servite. And it's good. Number two. Ben Vandenberg there, getting his first points tonight.
Servite going on a quick 5-2 run as they're now employing a full court defense.
Yeah, we've seen the full court press used a lot against the Eagles in some previous matchups, especially against Jay Sarah.
But we've seen the Eagles easily break it as they've done right now.
Yeah, as Preston Lee's trapped in the corner, he's going to get rid of it. And there's Moxie up top. Moxie's going to drive to the lane, going to kick it out to Preston Lee for three. And it's good!
Another
Preston Lee, second three of the night for him. 6 points on the day. Uh,
4:47 remaining here in the second quarter. Zapp's going to be down low, and that one's going to be wild. Moxley's going to recover that one. And McNamee's back in the game here as he drives to the lane. And they're going to call that one out of bounds.
You know, going back to what I was saying about Coach Bell, he really emphasizes hard work on defense. It's not so much on offense as, yeah, sure, you get an open shot, you make it. But his goal is so you play hard every time you're on the court.
Yeah, and they're going to give it to Rockwell down low. That one doesn't fall. He had about three guys on him there, but still able to get the shot up.
Freak of nature, Rockwell Reynolds.
They're going to kick that one to the corner for three. No good, Ben Vandenberg.
The Eagles have been doing really good at their closeouts.
They have, and I know you emphasize it. Coach Bell talks a lot about playing big physical defense. That
right.
Three for McNamee. That one doesn't fall.
As in the pregame for this game, you saw the Eagles, the first thing they did was closeouts.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, Coach Bell's very physical on defense, and it's a lot of the reason why the Eagles had so much success over the last few years under his time here. Alrighty, and there's going to be a...
Preston Lee subs out of the game for Braden Kynan for the Eagles.
Servite makes a substitution as well. As number 23, Leo Hanan, comes out of the game for Servite. They're going to take one to the house. The floater's blocked by Rockwell. He said, not today. And Kynan with the behind-the-back layup there.
And a questionable foul is called.
They give him the foul call. Servite bench not happy with that one.
Neither is the coach.
Oh man, what a block by Rockwell Reynolds. He's Dikembe Mutombo style. Not today. Not in my house.
No.
This is going to be two shots for Kynan here, the line. 3:39 remaining in the second quarter. Rare miss at the line for Kynan. This is usually money at the free throw line. Again, it's interesting that both of these teams have a freshman in the starting five. Obviously, Braden Kynan for the Eagles has been starting the entire year. And for Servite, Aaron Bilastrieri, the guard, he's 5'11", and he's a freshman. And obviously, he's the point guard. He's primary ball handler. So it's nice to see some freshmen on varsity, which is obviously very impressive for both of those young men. Kick it down low in the post for Schultz. He's going to get doubled. See if he can get out of this. There's the jump ball. Ball's going to stay with Servite.
Toby Everill, number 14, really has a high work ethic, you know?
Yeah, for sure. You know, with Ethan Ree injured for the Eagles, he's been able to really step in here into the starting lineup. And there's going to be the reverse layup. Good. For Jacob Martin, the sophomore. Gets his first points of the night. Going to kick that one to Kynan. Kyman's going to kick it to Moxie. Out to McNamee. Back to Averill. See if Moxie can orchestrate a play here.
As Moxie was looking to Coach Bell for a play, you're going to see that often.
And Moxie really controls the game sometime. You know, he's a real playmaker on the court. So the shot clock winds down here. Rockwell Reynolds down low. He's going to have to put something up. The layup is good. Rockwell Reynolds gets his four points in the night now for him. Been relatively quiet.
I'm surprised you didn't say your favorite phrase. Bread and butter.
You know, I didn't. I don't know why I didn't. You know, Rockwell Reynolds has been kind of quiet tonight, but, if he gets going here, that's going to be a lot of trouble for the Friars. As we have 2:26 remaining in the second quarter here. All righty, you can see that isolation up top to Moxie. Okay. There's Scott Scholes at the top. And the shot clock winds down. They're going to be forced to put that up. That one way off. Now Moxie's going to take it up the court. And there's McNamee. going to kick it down to Rockwell here in the post. See if Rockwell can cook up here. Let him cook indeed. Rockwell Reynolds, 6 points on the night. Alrighty, and Aaron's gonna drive there. No good on the layup.
I like the confidence by Aaron there. 5'11", as Frank said before.
Yeah.
Going against a 6'8 Rockwell Reynolds.
There's Kyman up top for three. Splash. Braden Kyman knocks down his first three of the night.
You said before that, Rockwell's been quiet, but everyone on the Eagles, including Rockwell.
They've been focusing on him, but it's been allowed opportunities for other guys. There's the block there for Rockwell Reynolds. But, when they have all that pressure on Rockwell, it allows for guys like Akaiman and McNamee to get open threes up top. It's just under a minute to remaining here in the first half. Just Eagles lead 32-14. Moxie's going to kick that to Averill. Just like you draw it up, easy layup. 4 points tonight now for Averill. Again, has been the sixth man all year, but when Ethan Reed went out with that lower body injury, Averill stepped in the starting lineup. He's been a key contributor here. He was really great on defense. All right, 30 seconds remaining in the first half. There's Bilastieri there.
As Eagles are playing,
Scott Scholes
double
in the corner
teams.
For three. No good. And he's going to try to get save that one, but it's going to be going back to the Friars here. With 13.3 remaining in the first half, Eagles lead by 20.
Smart play for David Roberts, number 21, bouncing off the Eagles player Rockwell Reynolds.
So Servite for another opportunity. Going to try to get the final shot here. All right, see what Servite can get here. Bolstery up top. And there's going to be the forced three. No good. All righty, and that's going to send it to the half as the Eagles lead 34-14. All righty, and we have our sideline reporter, Nick Augustini, here, who's going to talk to Coach Bell about the first half in just a few moments. All righty. All right, Nick, take it away.
Coach Bell, obviously some great success going into halftime with the lead. What do you tell your guys at half in the locker room to, keep the energy going into the second half?
Good question. We just got to keep our foot on the gas defensively, keep playing hard. The offense will take care of itself. We just keep defending hard, playing hard. We'll be in good shape.
So on defense, I saw guys jumping into the lane. You got a few blocks down low. Was that the game plan going in, or are the guys just getting really aggressive on defense?
No, that's the game plan. We just want to keep trying to grow our defensive mentality. I mean, it takes a long time to become a good defensive team, and we just want to keep doing it and doing it and doing it.
So going into the second half, on the defensive front, are you just trying to get defense to offense, or what's the offensive game plan?
The offense, just let the ball move and just keep it flowing. We want our defense to try to create a little bit of offense for us.
Thank you, Coach Bell.
Thank you, man.
All righty. Thank you, Nick, for that interview. As we enter into the half here, as we said, Eagles lead 34-14. Alrighty. So, Aiden, what do you think has gone right so far for the Eagles?
Yeah, definitely good ball movement and good defense on both ends. Eagles controlling the boards, offensive rebound. Really, everything's been going well for the Eagles, and it's really all about controlling the tempo of the second half as well.
Yeah, definitely. And as we talked about, even though Rockwell Reynolds only has 4 points, like him being like so heavily defended down there in the post has opened up so many open shots for everyone else, Alrighty. So we have a short break here at halftime as the Eagles lead by 20. We will be back in about 10 minutes here for the start of the second half.
Media.
And we're back from the half at the Moyzo Pavilion in Santa Margarita, California, as your Eagles lead 34-14. And to kick things off here in the second half, we have Nick Augustini here for a sideline report. Nick, take it away.
More. I talked to Toby Averill, and he said they want to keep their foot on the gas pedal defensively in the second half.
Alrighty, thank you, Nick, for that insight. As we're about to kick off here in the second half. Alrighty, as the Eagles lead by 20. They've played a very good game so far. So, Aiden, for those who hasn't been watching the entire half, what has the Eagles done right so far in this game?
Eagles, like they've been doing each and every game, played great perimeter defense. Let Servite make mistakes so Eagles can have easy opportunities on the other side.
Yeah, definitely.
Like I said before, that's Coach Bell's mentality to always have good defense.
Alrighty.
Because you heard this.
We're underway here. Moxie with the ball. And this is the screen for Rockwell. Averill in the corner.
Rockwell has a size advantage in the post.
Yeah, that's what we've talked about. He's been quiet tonight, but again, he's really opened up shots for other guys.
Quick
shot. McNamee for three. It's good. Money in the bank, Cameron McNamee.
Quick back and forth between Rockwell and Cameron.
Double-digit points now in the night for McNamee. 10 points for him.
Coach Bell always emphasizes quick closeouts.
The ref's going to whistle that one dead. Alrighty.
Alrighty.
Alrighty indeed. Okay. So we're just underway here in the second half. If the Eagles can keep it up here, we might see some of the secondary string guys come in here. Okay. There's Ballesteri up top. He's been on that ISO on Moxie all game. We don't get much from it.
Quick switches on defense for the Eagles.
Shane Williams with the ball. Kicks it to Brendan Tom, and the little floater is good.
Nice control around the rim for Servite.
Definitely. Again, Servite with the small ball lineup. It's going to be interesting to see if they can get down low.
Yeah, they're definitely not afraid to go in the paint.
They're going to kick it Rockwell down low, but that pass is deflected away. The ball is going to stay with the Eagles.
Number 21 for Servite, Davin Roberts, definitely saw that coming as they've been as the Eagles have been feeding Rockwell Reynolds all night.
Yeah, they have. And what we've talked about is when they crash to Rockwell, it opens up guys up top for easy shots.
Yep, it opens
them
up.
There's Rockwell down low. The layup is good. Rockwell Reynolds, 8 points on the night. Let's see if he can start to pick things up here in the second half. As usually, he's a lot of times the leading scorer for the Eagles.
Eagles are in their man defense.
There's Ballesteri on the wing. Going to kick it to Scholes. He's going to think about it. He's going to get the little spin move in the post, and that one isn't able to fall for the Friars. Alrighty. There's Kyman up top. Kick it to Moxie. That pass is deflected. And there's the fast break here for the Friars, and the layup is good. Shane Williams on the fast break.
Definitely their best play of the night. We'll for sure give them some momentum going into this third quarter.
As we see Preston Lee ready to sub in there. Looks like they might be subbing him in for Moxie at the next whistle.
He's a key six man for this Eagles.
Yeah. And there's the fadeaway for Rockwell. No good. Alrighty, and there's
so
Shane
far,
Williams with the ball.
So far, Servite's been able to keep up with the Eagles this quarter.
This half, yes, they have, which has been interesting. And that one's going to get tipped. Rockwell Reynolds is going to come up with it. And there's Mox. He's going to get a wild pass. He's going to go out of bounds. He's going to be going the other way. All right. So Preston Lee in for Braden Kyman here. Is Kyman getting some rest as he played almost the entire first half? Kyman, a key piece for the Eagles. So that's going to be Scholes down low. And that one, he's going to lose it. And Rockwell's going to come up with it. Tried to get down in the post there against Rockwell.
Yep.
Got doubled. Couldn't come up with it. Because that one's going to be deflected down low, too. A lot of loose balls.
below the rim to start the second half.
Yeah, exactly. You know, the Eagles are making some kind of questionable mistakes going into this third quarter.
Yeah. Man, you know, hopefully they don't get too comfortable with the lead. You know, they're up 21 with 4:53 remaining in the third quarter. Alrighty, and there's Ballesteri with the ball. He's been playing almost the entire game here, and then the pull-up jumper for Scholes, no good.
Quick jump shot.
Yeah, nothing but net.
You're not wrong.
Indeed, I'm not. There's Preston Lee, going to give it to Moxie. We see Preston Lee and Moxie in the game at the same time. Usually don't see that, because they're the 2 point guards for the Eagles.
Two-point guard starting lineup. Quick right, pass to Rockwell.
I mean, what do you say? Bread and butter. I mean, he was just wide open down low there. Just a miscommunication on defense for the Friars.
As now Rockwell Reynolds have 10 points in this third quarter.
The ref's going to call that one. All right. And we are about halfway through the third quarter here. 4:04 remaining in the third. Eagles lead 41-18.
Now we see Dallas Washington coming in for Toby Averill for the Eagles. And Dallas Washington definitely making his presence known with a quick interception of the ball.
But yeah, Aiden, I know we were talking about it earlier at the half. Like, really, Coach Bell, his rotation only consists of about 7 or 8 guys, which is kind of interesting. You know, he really doesn't get many guys off the bench here. He likes to stick with his guys that he can trust, you know?
Yeah, like you said, stick with the guys you can trust, and the guys he trusts can make the good plays.
Yeah.
When it's close games like this, Coach Bell needs guys that he can trust.
Yeah. That'll be interesting come playoffs for the Eagles, how they utilize the bench.
Especially if Ethan Reed comes back healthy.
Yeah, we don't know a timetable on his injury, but he's definitely a key piece. And as we've said, props to Toby Averill, the junior, who stepped into Reed's spot in the starting lineup. Usually Averill had been the sixth man to start the year, but with the Ethan Reed injury, he's been in the starting lineup, and he's made his presence known on defense for sure. But really off the bench, the Eagles really only use about 3 guys at the bench. They use Preston Lee, Dallas Washington, and
As there seems to have been a uniform situation with Jonathan Moxie not tucking in his jersey.
Yeah, always got to stay professional on the court. Alrighty. And that one's going to get intercepted by the Friars. So they're going to take that one to the lane, and he draws the foul. Number 23, Leo Hanan, the sophomore.
You have to be really careful about those passes that you make.
Yeah, just have to have some little better court vision there from Lee. As, you know, he wasn't really looking there, and he just got that one intercepted by Hanan.
3 minutes, 47 seconds left in this third quarter.
2 shots here for Leo Hanan. So, Aiden, let's I know you talked about this. Let's talk a little bit about the upcoming schedule for the Eagles. As obviously, you know, we have this game tonight and big game this Friday night. The Eagles are at home and they take on the Modern Day Monarchs. Should be a great game. And again, catch it all here on Eagle TV 2.0. Gabe will be live stream tip off at 7 p.m. Make sure to stay tuned for that one. Should be a great game.
That will definitely be a game for the ages.
Definitely test this Eagles. Eagles, you know, 18-3 coming into this one. And that modern day game will really be a test for them. That one's stolen in the paint.
You know, two of the best teams in Orange County, you know, going at it. It's definitely going to be a popular game for both modern day fans and the Eagles fans.
Yeah. Nest should be here in full cheering on the Eagles. You know, Friday night. You know, again, Friday nights here at the Moisel Pavilion are always a fun time. And that one's going to get deflected by Rockwell.
And, Jack, what we said earlier about that modern day game, you know, that's going to be a key game. Like, especially going into the playoffs after February 2nd.
Yeah, because modern day, as of right now, is third in the Trinity League. Is that 3 off for Moxie?
As the Eagles have only scored 7 points this entire quarter.
Yeah, this quarter it's been 7-6 in favor of the Eagles. The Friars have scored 6 themselves. Been a low-scoring quarter. The Eagles lead by 21 with 2:52 remaining this quarter. All right, but yeah, as we're talking about that Mario Day game, you know, we need everyone here. So, you know, for all the students out there, make sure you come, fill the nest. You know, we need to be loud for that one. And if you're not able to catch it in person, as we said, all the action here on the Eagle TV 2.0 Sports YouTube channel. So make sure to tune into that one. And there's the alley-oop for Washington. Almost gets that one to fall out. Man, that would have been a great play.
Definitely would have gave the Eagles some energy to end this third quarter.
As we talk about the momentum, as that layup falls for Ballesteri. But yeah, always it's momentum. You know, one like big play like that can really turn the tides of the game. You know, an electric play like that fires up the bench, fires up everybody, and that really can get going. Because Moxie can be doubled there. He's going to kick it to Lee. Lee with a pull-up jumper. It's good. Preston Lee. Preston Lee with 8 points on the night off the bench.
Definitely a great six-man for this Eagles team.
Yeah, Preston Lee having a great game here. He's the junior standing at 6 foot. Alrighty, and that one's going to kicked out up top. So we see that great perimeter defense in effect for the Eagles. The pull-up jumper, top of the key, no good. Good. But they are going to call the foul there.
Friars
love that
the refs.
Little pull-up jumper from the top of the key. Alrighty, we're going to have 2 shots here at the line for the Friars. So that's number 15, Jacob Martin, the sophomore guard. As Toby Averill checks in for Preston Lee here with 2:03 remaining as the Eagles lead by 20. Make that 19 now.
2 minutes and 3 seconds left
in this
third quarter.
Full court press here from the Friars, as they are still very much into this game. Eagles need to get this one beyond half court. That one's stolen by the Friars. Full court press shows effective for Tony Davis and his squad.
Really one of the only times throughout these games that we've announced where a full court press actually worked against the Eagles.
Yeah, the Eagles have been very good against the full court press. Pretty much all of these games we've covered, Aiden, the other team's been trying to use that full court press, and the Eagles have done a good job of getting around it. So I think Coach Bell probably prepares for that a lot in practice.
As oh, most definitely.
A lot of teams are.
Most definitely.
All right, and that one's deflected by Moxie. Moxie has the ball. He's going to drive to the lane, and it's good. Jonathan Moxie takes that one to the lane.
Definitely
and
an
and-one
type of play.
Be a timeout there. With a minute 35 left in the third quarter. Alrighty. Okay, so we have a 60-second timeout here. So, Aiden, what do you think Tony Davis and his squad for the Friars, what do you think he's talking about in the huddle at the moment?
Well, Jack, the full court press shown by the Servite Friars definitely worked against the Eagles as they had a turnover recently. I'd say, like, keep the pressure on, keep doing full court press because it's working in this game, and just keep the pressure on.
Yeah,
and it'll chip away that 21-point lead held by the Eagles.
You know, stay into it, even though as we come close to the end of the third quarter here, you know, Eagles still lead by 21. But, you know, the Friars are going to – I have a feeling, you know, they're telling him to stay into the game, you know, stay aggressive, and they're not going to, you know, give up here. We have a minute 35 remaining in the quarter. All right, the inbound here for the Friars. Going to give it to Ballesteri. All righty. And this is going to be contested there. Servite is going to come up with it. The step back.
Good contest by Rocco Reynolds using his long wingspan.
Yeah, that long wingspan coming into play there. That step back just a little short. All right. There's Ballesteri up top.
He's going to kick it out top tree to see if they get some kind of shot here. Ballesteros open for three. No good.
Another good closeout by the Eagles. Cammy McNamee with a great closeout.
Yeah, definitely. All right, we're going to see Rockwell.
Rockwell Reynolds
thinks about getting it down low on the post, decides against it.
Channeling his inner playmaker.
Yeah, you know, as we talked about, there's McNamee's going to think about the three, and they're going to call the travel on McNamee there. You know, as we were talking about, the thing with the Eagles on defense is, like, you know, they all their guys, there's no liabilities. Everyone there is athletic. Even Rockwell, the big man, you know, he's athletic.
Oh, definitely, for sure.
All righty. All right, we have 32 seconds remaining in the third quarter here. See what Servite has is Ballesteros with the ball up top, trying to get that isolation on Moxie. That one's going to get stolen by Washington. And the ref's going to call the foul for that one.
Definitely a physical game shown by the Eagles as they're not letting Servite come close to pulling away.
Yeah, for sure. All right, 19.5 left in the quarter.
Servite Friars look to have the final shot.
Hasn't been a score in over a minute here. As there's the little pull-up jumper, no good. Alrighty, 8 seconds remaining. But yeah, almost 2 minutes here with no points for either teams.
Like you said, Jack, a very low scoring third quarter for both teams. Another full court press by Servite.
So 8 seconds here, Eagles gonna get the final shot, see what they can do with it. 5 seconds left, Moxie's gonna drive to the lane. Lays that one in just like jelly. Jonathan Moxie with the layup to end the third quarter. 47-24, Eagles lead, end of three. I mean, man, that one's just jelly off the fingers there
for sure.
Jonathan Moxie. Love to see it. He got really close to the rim
for
there.
Sure. Friars did not expect that. They were expecting a shot, but definitely not a go-ahead layup.
Definitely. All righty, we have Nick Augustini standing on the sidelines. Nick, take it away.
Bit of a sloppy quarter for the Eagles, but you did hear Coach Bell say earlier that he was trying to tighten up things on defense. You heard Toby say, Toby told me after halftime that they were really trying to pick it up on defense and just keep it rolling. So defense is obviously the main focus for the Eagles. You did see them working on some things. They tried out a new inbounds play, trying to get a free bucket for Dallas. Let's see what the fourth quarter has in store for the Eagles, but it is going to be a defensive game.
All right. Thank you, Nick, for that report. As we are at the end of three here at the Moiso Pavilion. Beautiful night here in Santa Margarita. Nice Wednesday night, Trinity League basketball action. So we're about to resume here in the fourth quarter. So Aiden, obviously going into this final quarter of play here, Eagles lead by 23. What do you think we can expect here in this fourth quarter? Obviously, you know, turning into a little bit of a big lead here for the Eagles where Coach Bell might start to get comfortable with using some of his second string players.
And like you said, if that happens, Coach Bell uses second string, then really the Eagles, look, Servite would want to make the Eagles employ careless mistakes, obviously. And they'd want to come back. Servite wants to come back in this game. They're desperate. They'll do anything to make this an even game.
Yeah. Servite, 0-2 in Trinity Leagues. That one's going to be a loose ball.
Good hustle by Toby Averill.
So that one's going to deflect it. Moxie's going to come up with it. Cross-court pass to McNamee.
Dangerous pass, but
so there's Rockwell up top with the spin moves. Going to drive to the lane, loses the ball. The floater, no good. As we said, Servite 0-2 in Trinity League play so far, 11-6 on the season. Looking for their first Trinity League win. And Washington's not going to be able to get that
good
one.
Good attempt by Dallas Washington.
Yeah, you know, assuming everything goes to play here, Friars are going to fall to 0-3 on Trinity League, which, you know, they're obviously looking for their first win of the year, you know. I mean, if they want to come back in this one, they're going to need a magic lamp and all three wishes for that one. So. Alrighty.
Yeah, you know, coming into this.
Ballesteros, Scholes, baseline jumper. No good, but they are going to call the foul.
You know, going into this fourth quarter, the Eagles only scored 11 points. Definitely, like we said before, a low-scoring game. And Yeah, there's definitely going to be momentum so we have for Friday night's game.
Yeah, 7:13 left in this game. Eagles lead 47-24. As we said, big game this Friday, modern day. This will be a real test for this Eagles squad to see if they really have what it takes to go far in the CIF playoffs come February. So, again, make sure stay tuned for that one. That should be a really good game. And it'll be right here in the Moisel Pavilion. Nest is going to be loud. That free throw falls for the Friars. Yeah, oh, and that one almost stolen by the Friars. Just really fast-paced here. Mock's going to have the ball. Going to kick it to Kaiman. The corner three for Kaiman. Bang! Braden Kaiman. Money in the bank for three. So that's going to be 9 points on the day now for the freshman Braden Kaiman.
Servite's best attempt at defense still end up with a shot for the Eagles.
Yeah, I mean the Eagles just playing great here tonight. And, I mean, the Eagles have a lot of momentum. That Jay Sarah win on Friday was great. Obviously, beating that crosstown rival always gives you some momentum. Coming into tonight, you know, they got the job done. A little bit of a more slower-paced game. You know, not as intense, obviously, because, like, you know, not as much of a crowd here because it's on Wednesday night. But, again, this fourth quarter is going to be important going into modern day to build some momentum.
And, you know, I noticed going into this fourth quarter, Coach Bell had Dallas Washington up top to avoid a cross-court pass. And you see Dallas Washington with this long wingspan could negate that.
Pull-up jumper, good. From about 20 feet out for number 15, Jacob Martin. So, yeah, this upcoming schedule is going to tell a lot here for the Eagles, as we've talked about, Aiden. You know, obviously the modern day game and then the Olu game after that. So that three is going to be off for Kaiman, but he gets the rebound. Kaiman down low is going to lose that one. It's going to be going the other way. But, yeah, if we take a look at the Trinity League standings here, Santa Margarita currently at the top with their 18-3 record, 2-0 in Trinity League. Assuming no miraculous comebacks, they will move to 19-3, 3-0 in Trinity League. They stand at the top here. You know, they're really the team to beat in the Trinity League. You know, they haven't had that many close games. I mean, Jay Sarah, they won by 14. This one, they're going to win by a good amount.
Definitely.
You know, they're the team to beat.
And what's interesting to note is modern day is 1-2 in Trinity League. And
yeah,
throughout our 4 years in high school, we've seen that modern day has been the dominant.
McDamay from three. Money in the bank, Cameron McDamay. That corner shot is just absolutely money for him. What, have a night, McDamay. 13 points on the night.
You know, modern day's been a powerhouse throughout our 4 years in high school. And so this could be a great chance for Eagles to dethrone the Kings Orange County basketball.
I mean, modern day really just owns, like, high school sports in the Trinity League. I mean, modern day is, like, the Alabama, so to say. They are the powerhouse of the Trinity League. So it'll be good to – oh, my goodness! Dallas Washington, are you kidding me? The alley-oop throws it down, and now the – Moisel Pavilion is rocking after that one.
Raise the roof.
Oh, my gosh. What a play there. Dallas Washington slams that one down. Puts his man on a poster for that one. I mean, wow, what an electric play. I mean, like we say, a play like that, you know, obviously this game, a little out of reach here for the Friars, but if this one was close of game, a play like that is what can, like, swing the momentum, you know, and it got – a play like that, you know, the momentum could swing into Friday night, hopefully.
Yeah, for sure.
Big game. As we're talking about, modern day, 14-4 on the year, 1-2 in Trinity League. You know, don't let the record deceive you. Modern day is still a very good team, and they are, you know, as we said, they are kind of the kings of the Trinity League in every sport. So it'll be interesting to see if they can take them down. Yeah. So in Trinity League play so far, the only undefeated teams is Santa Margarita and St. John Bosco. They're both 2-0. Santa Margarita going to move to 3-0 here as there's 4:51 left in the game. See, it'll be interesting. A game to mark on the calendar is February 2nd. St. John Bosco is the finale of the season, regular season here for the Eagles. It's going to be here at home. It's a Wednesday night. The Eagles will take on the Braves, and that'll be a good game because those two teams have kind of shown to be the two top dogs in the Trinity League. So that one will be the finale. So that could be very important for seeding in CIF as those teams might be tied with each other.
definitely be a game to watch coming into Friday.
Yeah. That one's going to get called. All right, 55-30, the Eagles lead here in the fourth quarter.
4 minutes, 40 seconds to go.
But, yeah, if we look, take a look at the Trinity League standings, Eagles at the top with their 18-3 record, 2-0 in Trinity League.
Quick pass to Toby.
Averill with the layup is good. And, yeah, St. John Bosco, 16-3 overall, 2-0 Trinity League. And then we have Orange Lutheran at 11-6, 2-1 in the Trinity League. And then right behind them is Mater Dei with their 14-4 record, 2-1 Trinity League. So that jumper good for the Friars. Yeah, after that, you got Jay Sarah below them, 13-5, 0-2 in Trinity. And Servite at the bottom, 11-6, 0-2 in Trinity, about to be 0-3. Alrighty.
Another good game to watch. Yeah. February 2nd, St. John Bosco, second in Trinity San Luis, 16-3. Also 2-0 in Trinity League.
Yeah,
so that would also be a defining game for the Eagles this season.
Alrighty. Halfway through the fourth quarter, here's Averill puts up the corner three, and it's good. Toby Averill knocks it down from the corner.
If not already, that was the dagger.
I think the dagger was a while ago, my friend. 3:36 remaining here. Eagles lead 60-32. It's been an overall great game here for Coach Bell and his squad as we see Duke Luol on the sideline ready to check in here.
Eagle TV's 2.0's one and only Dear Duke is coming into the game.
We had our episode of Dear Duke today. Now he's going to be subbing in the game. Shot clock winds down. Scholes is going to have to put it up unless he passes it, and he gets that one off. No good. All righty. This one should be interesting here. Number 22, Duke Luol checks into the game for Toby Averill. As you can see here, the crowd yelling, Dude.
The people's champ enters the game.
Definitely a fan favorite, Duke Luol. Duke Luol stands at 7'1". Obviously, he's an Oberlin College commit. He's the senior. Obviously, a face around campus. Everyone knows Duke. It'll be interesting to see what he can do here.
As Duke Luol's in the post.
Duke Luol in the post. They're going to give it to him. There's two guys on him. Loses that one.
As soon as Duke Luol touches the ball, two defenders collapse on him. And unfortunately, that's what's going to happen when you're 7'1".
Yeah. I mean, again, Duke is just a fan favorite. I mean, he's the homecoming king. You know, everyone loves him around campus. And obviously, you know, he's hard to miss with that height. You know, whenever he walks into our studio for his Dear Duke, he has to duck to get into the door, which is always funny. All right, Kyman with the pull-up jumper, and it's good right off the glass for Kyman.
As the Eagles now lead by 30 points with 2 minutes, 36 left to go.
Quick
in
three
this fourth
for
quarter.
Servite. Just rims out there. All righty, Preston Lee up top. Kicks it to Averill. Duke Luol sets the screen. Doesn't get anything from it.
Double dribble by Toby Averill. Yep,
double dribble by Averill there. All right. So with 2:19 remaining in the game, let's take a look at the Eagles' upcoming schedule here. Obviously, again, this game pretty much out of reach for the Friars, so they will move to 19-3. Mater Dei, as we said, big game this Friday. After that, though, they're going to take on St. John Bosco at St. John Bosco on Wednesday, the 18th at 7:30. So that one will be in Bellflower. And then after that, we will have a home game on Friday the 20th against Orange Lutheran. Should be a good game as Olu stands at third in the Trinity League. And then after that, they go to Jay Sarah on the 25th, take them on Wednesday. And then Friday, they are at Servite again on the 27th. And then the last week of the season, so that three falls for Leo Hanan. We're moving into the last week of the season. They'll take on Mater Dei at Mater Dei on Tuesday the 31st, and they'll close out the season on Thursday the 2nd, home against St. John Bosco. Should be a good game. Get some momentum rolling into the playoffs.
Definitely a tough schedule for the Eagles, but one they can manage as they have beaten teams that have been speculated to be better than their team.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, Mater Day might be one of the first games of the year where, you know, Eagles, I would think they would be slightly favored as they are at the top, but Mater Day will be very tough.
As Dute Lawal has called for a three-second violation in the paint.
Yeah. Dute Lawal, you know, it's always fun to see him in the game.
As now we see the rest of the subs come in. Brandon Lewis, Jonathan Knowles subbing in.
As time winds down here in this game, 7 minutes left in the game. Eagles lead 64-35. So, yeah, that upcoming schedule, it's tough. I mean, it's Trinity League. It's, you know, a super tough division in every sport. Is I don't know where that pass was going. But as we said, very tough division to play in, so it's always tough. So Trinity League basketball always is tough to do. And so going into the schedule, I know you said, Aiden, it's going to be interesting to see here.
Yeah,
how
sure.
They perform.
55 seconds left in this
fourth
quarter.
As we see
quarter.
The starters check out here with a minute to go. Brandon Lewis for three, and it's good. Brandon Lewis. Would you look at that? The four-year player, Brandon Lewis, knocks that one down from the wing. Always fun to see guys like that.
Good fake, Mark. Good fake.
30 seconds left. So, yeah, as we were talking about, Aiden, just overall, great game. Perimeter defense on point. Cameron McNamee was money from beyond the arc. Rockwell Reynolds, you know, he didn't put up as many points, but he opened up a lot of opportunities for other guys.
Braden Kiman with 13 points.
Yeah. Overall, great team win for the Eagles as this one winds down. And this fourth quarter, they had a lot of, I mean, that alley-oop from Dallas Washington really fired up the crowd.
Definitely,
you know,
electric.
That Brandon Lewis three got everyone going. So hopefully they can build some momentum going into this Friday night. Big, big game against the Monarchs. That'll be really fun. And as we previously mentioned, make sure to tune into that one on the Eagle TV 2.0 YouTube channel on Friday night. All right, 25.7 left. Eagles lead by 30. As they're just going to dribble this one out here. So as this game comes to a close, again, Aiden, what do you think really the key was for the Eagles? Like, we talked about McNamee there, but it was just what do you think really went right?
Definitely good defense. Very disciplined from the start of this first quarter to the end. Coach Bell has a strict policy and really led Eagles to win by 30.
Yeah. So that's the final score. Eagles win 67-37 on this Wednesday night here at the Moiso Pavilion. And we'll have our sideline reporter Nick Augustini in a few moments interviewing Rockwell Reynolds on his performance. Yes. As you see the handshake here. Another win for the Eagles.
This game
Eagles move to 19-3 on the year, 3-0 in Trinity League, and the Friars fall to 11-7 on the season, 0-3 in Trinity League play.
Definitely a confidence booster for the Eagles as they're heading to their next game Friday the 13th against Mater Dei.
Friday the 13th. That'll be fun. Yeah, that's their next game lined up right back here in the Moiso Pavilion. And it's overall great team win from the Eagles. Alrighty. And we have Nick Augustini standing by here with Rockwell Reynolds. All right, and he has Brandon Lewis there also in the interview. So, Nick, let's see what you got.
Yeah, I'm here with Brandon and Rockwell after a good game. Brandon, I'm going to start with you. You're in the game for like 3 seconds and you hit a three. How are you feeling right now?
Oh, no, it's amazing, man. It's an amazing feeling. We had a small student section, but they really came out and they were really loud and they're really supportive.
You know, the guys were all telling me to interview you. So what was it like in the locker room? What's it going to be like in the locker room in a few minutes? You know, all you guys together, what's the energy?
It's just going to be good vibes, man. We're going to be working for Friday and come out, support the Mater Dei game.
Okay, Rockwell, I'm going to come over to you. Obviously, Coach Bell said it many times, the focus was defense. You know, you got a few blocks. What was your energy on defense, and how did you get some of those stops?
Yeah, we just got to just stay down, and just defense is all about playing hard, so we just had to play hard through the whole entirety of the game. And, I mean, we only let up 37 points. Pretty good
yeah.
Game, I'll say.
On the offensive side, you know, you had some buckets. You were pounding it in low to you. So, you know, how do you – you know, maneuver in the paint, and how are you going to try and work on that for next game?
Well, our next game is Modern Day, so they're tough, but they're coming off a loss, so they'll be hungry. But just got to watch for the double teams, kick it out to the open shooter. If not, I'll go and score, and we should be fun.
Perfect. Thank you, guys. You know, everyone go out and support these guys at Modern Day next on Friday.
All right. Thank you, Nick, for that interview. As we've really mentioned, they talked about that big matchup with Modern Day. So final score here, 67-37. Eagles win on this Wednesday night. Just overall great team win as they move into that big matchup this Friday at Modern Day. Make sure to tune into that one. So great team win for the Eagles here. As we wrap up here, I'm Jack Frankenfield.
And I'm Aiden Verde.
All right, and we'll see you Friday night at 7 p.m. as the Eagles take on the Monarchs back here in the Moiso Pavilion. Signing off.